Hey guys, Max and Max's Models here, and tonight we're doing messages from the Mustang. Thought I'd do something different. I know we've had some volume issues, so I'm going to try and crank the volume up on this one for you. Anyway, I'm out here getting some takeout for my wife and I for dinner, and I thought perfect night to take the Mustang out. Even got my Mustang t-shirt on, and I thought, well, you know what the heck, let's do something a little bit different, and I'll just do my video from here. There's no one else in the parking lot, so I can shout as loud as I want. a lot of progress on the Caterham today. Got the engine installed, and unfortunately, although Tamiya has great instructions, there's still some issues with trying to figure out exactly how to route some of the tubing, and you have the issues with the chrome on chrome gluing and the rubber on chrome and a few things like that, some stuff that doesn't want to stick. So that kind of slows up the progress, because we're into the point now where we're actually gluing a lot of stuff together, not screwing it together, although there's still plenty of screws to be had. A little bit of an argument, things didn't quite line up right, which is always the case, but I finally got everything installed. Biggest problem is not breaking what I've already done, because there's so many things sticking out on the car. But pretty much got the engine installed. Still got a lot of work to do on it. Going to be installing the clutch pedals and interior. Did get the seats in. And, you know, it's just moving along. Progress is slow and steady, but it is steady. On the DC3, had a lot of trouble sealing up the spine along the back of the airplane. Using that styrene, the stuff that Chuck sent me, the tools he sent me, worked out fine. Really good, but I used putty along the fuselage, and it took about four tries of putty, sand, prime, and the ridge was still visible, and the putty wasn't going into the seam, so I used some of the tools he gave me sort of as a spatula and wedged it down in there. Finally, on about the fourth try, I got it smoothed out. It's looking good now, so hopefully I have that done in a couple of days. That's really about it. You know, I just thought about something. I opened up that little Keil kit Sopwith camel today, and one way you could date it was by the price tag inside. 25p? That has to be from the 50s. I was also thinking about the DC3. I think one of the reasons that the fuselage didn't seal up the way it should, very possibly because it's been on the shelf for 8 or 10 years, so it's probably gotten a little warped over time, possibly given as big as it is. And another thought that popped in my head, because, you know, I don't have a script for these things, just, you know, flow of consciousness kind of thing, was that the clutches, the brake pedal clutch assembly on the Caterham, I'm getting ready to put that in tomorrow, and they actually have rubber foot pads for the that you glue on to the brake. Oh, they're ready for me, for the brake and the clutch. Not the gas pedal, brake clutch, they have little square rubber pads. Well, I thought it was pretty cool. And now back to your regularly scheduled program. So I'll run some pictures for you. I hope you guys are having a great evening. Really not much else to talk about tonight. There is one more thing. I'm sorry, just one more thing. I'm leaving town Friday and won't be back till early next week. Part of it's a trip, work, and part of it's to go see some friends. So there won't be any content after Thursday until sometime next week. I'm hoping to go to the American Heritage Museum up in Massachusetts. So I'll try to make a video on that, although I might not get that put together till I get home. But there are plenty of gazillion videos out there on it already, so probably won't be anything new. But try to take a lot of good snapshots for all you armor guys who use it for modeling, as if you want to model something there. They have a lot of great artifacts, tanks, and things. They have one of the only M1 Abrams that's on civilian display. Not quite sure how they swung that one. I think it's a little Marine Corps tank. Anyway, so Thursday night will be the last content for at least 5 days. So take care of yourselves, guys. I hope you're having a wonderful evening, and as always, model on.